as you guys are kind of cooling down, letting your eyes adjust and taking pictures in here, since I don't know exactly how many caves you've been to, I'll give you a bit of the basics so you can kind of understand what's going on. So you'll probably hear a dripping sound every once in a while. You may even get drip on by the time we're out of here. Mm-hmm. And long story short, it's that dripping that's making the formations we're looking at. Because all throughout the ceiling are millions of little tiny holes called pores. Very similar to the pores in your face. And when it rains, water slowly works its way down through those, picks up very tiny minerals, and then leaves them behind in trails on the ceiling. Then over a long time, those trails have built up, and that's what makes these stalactites. Any questions so far?
In the winter time, is the temperature very different? Is there much differential between the...
Actually, there is zero difference. It is 60 degrees in here right now, and that will stay the same if it's 120 degrees outside or 20 below zero.
Smooth. Minerals.
What's up?
Why did the rock feel fake?
Good question. So remember how I told you there's pores in the ceiling? There's also pores in the formations that it makes. So whenever you touch the rock, the little bits of your skin oil go into those pores and sit down at the bottom. So that in itself doesn't really do anything, but if enough people touch it, that skin oil goes all the way to the top, it kind of polishes the rock, kind of like a counter.
So shiny, sparkly.
Oh, that looks nice.
I want to do
the jellyfish is not named for what it looks like. It's actually named for where we're standing now. Because as odd as this sounds, we know of about 8 different couples that have actually gotten married here in the cave. And then, keeping with that theme, it gets a little bit weirder, because this area is called Lover's Leap. According to legend, if a couple stands here, holds hands, and jumps down to the rock down there, that if they're not hurt when they land, they truly love each other. So.
I just got dripped on my head. A beautiful hat. What's a coin?
Is it all limestone, or?
Yes, it leads straight down, so it follows the ceiling until it can.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. It looks like a river.
It does, yeah.
The way the spikes are formed,
here and there. We'll start with this one. It doesn't go back here as far as it looks.
Go back here?
I mean, you could, but as you can see, it just kind of stops right there. Go back. I'd say for about 30 or 40 feet. This is not layer 3 I was talking about. Well, I got you. I'll protect you. But if you guys are ready, we can go ahead and go down here. Just take your time with the top here especially. These are a little bit more narrow. And enjoy these stairs while we get to go down them because... Yes, I have. I've gone 3 good ways down that hill. Really long way. No, I just want to. Because this isn't nearly as deep as the woods. It's only about half a foot deep.
Oh, half a foot deep?
It looks like it, but that actually is long enough for me to stand up with.
Oh,
wow.
Can you just walk
down there? Yep. There's rocks down there. Every once in a while, there's one poking up. And you guys want to step because you're getting ready to go to the wettest part of the cave here. There's lots of dripping, lots of puddles, so just take your time. So that is the cleanest water you'll ever drink in this. Pretty much. I'll come down here and change light bulbs and look around. Either that or bring the laptop and play video games in the shop.
We'll change the light bulbs. Most people are good, true to text.
Yes, sir.
But you get a shot, you go and sleep.